Thank you for joining us today. If you live in Texas, do you think when you pass away that automatically your property is passed over to your loved one? Well, think again. Welcome to Chit Chat with Gina, your host Gina Barbera, and today I have Kathleen Cassidy Goodman, who is an attorney that is located in Helotes but practices law in Helotes and the San Antonio area, and she'll be sharing some valuable information with us today. Welcome, Kathleen. How are you?
Hi, Gina. Great. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, so Kathleen, how long have you been practicing law now?
Oh, actually, I graduated from law school in 1997. I went right here in San Antonio to St. Mary's Law School, and I've been practicing. Initially, I started off with a general practice, and it's evolved now so that what I'm doing now is just strictly probate and wills and trusts and preparing medical powers of attorney for people. So it's refined to an estate planning practice.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Boy, I bet you that is a very interesting meeting all types of different people and so forth, right? And
it is. We have a wide range of people. A lot of times in the past, it was mainly elderly people, mm-hmm. but with the problems that we have now with the coronavirus, we're getting many young people coming in as well. A lot of people are fearful that, you know, something might happen. Okay. And so we're doing a wider range of people coming in to have their wills and trusts prepared.
Well, it's never too right, never too early to prepare. I know that we don't like to think about the inevitable, right?
But right. Admit to our own mortality.
Yes, yes. Oh, my goodness. So what are some of the misconceptions that people might have when they pass, you know, what their property might be passed on to? Is there a lot of misconceptions that people think it automatically goes to their spouse? Or?
Yes, there are. One of the things that I've seen in my practice is people will think because their husband and wife, the two spouses, their names are both on the title to their house, there's an assumption that when their spouse passes away, that the property automatically passes to them and that they don't need to do anything. And that's totally incorrect. In Texas, what happens is when the first spouse passes away, even if both names are on the title, we still need to pass the property from one spouse to the other. And frequently people will wait, you know, they'll think, oh, I don't need to probate, it's just the house, that's all we have to do. But frequently I've seen the case where 10 years will pass and then the second spouse will die, and then the family is left with having to needing to transfer the property from the first spouse to the second spouse and then to the children. And so this can be very problematic. So it's one of the things that that people really need to tend to when the first spouse passes away.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So what are some things that people can do to prepare and make sure they're not caught off guard?
Yeah, one of the things that we do is the Texas legislature a few years back passed a law stating that couples, married couples, or even single people mm-hmm. could execute what's called a transfer on death deed. Okay. And in the transfer on death deed, you basically state who you want your property to pass to upon your death. And mm-hmm. so we do it for, it actually takes two deeds. Each spouse would execute a deed to their spouse, leaving their property, and then the property passes automatically when the person passes away.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So when doing that, does that mean then that you don't necessarily have to have a will, or what's?
We try to avoid probate, and that is one of the ways that you can avoid probate. But if you don't have a will, what I've seen in the past, and it's really quite a hardship, is mm-hmm. They don't have the money to do both a will and the transfer on death deed, so they'll say, oh, well, I'll just go with the transfer on death deed. And this creates a problem because if when the person passes away, mm-hmm. Say a week before they die, there's a hailstorm and we have $7,000 worth of damage and the check will come payable to the two spouses, then we have to get the check cashed. The bank won't cash the check because the person has passed away, so we have to go to probate in order to cash the check.
Oh,
and
wow.
So it's really important that you have both a transfer on death deed and hope that, you know, that works. But if something irregular comes out of the situation, if you have a will, it makes it much easier than not having a will. It can be very problematic to have to go to the court to probate if there is no will.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Wow. So what are some other misconceptions that people might have?
In the past, I have frequently had people come into my office, and I remember one instance in particular. Two ladies came in, and one friend was bringing her friend in, and I was explaining to her that when the first spouse passes away, you do have to do something. And a lot of people will think, oh, all I have to do is take the death certificate to the tax office, and that takes the name off the deed. And so friends will tell their friends, oh, I did it when my husband passed away. All you have to do is take the deed, the death certificate down to the tax office, and they'll take the name off the deed. What happens is the tax office will take the name off of the taxes, but the deceased spouse's name still remains on the deed, and that property has not been transferred. So there's a big misconception there.
Oh my goodness. Well, it sounds like there's a lot of things that we need to take care of just to be detailed, right? But is there, I guess, an easy way just to try to get it all together? I mean, I don't know. Maybe people just talking to you and being able to get an appointment set with you?
Yes. What we're doing now is, because of the COVID situation, we're offering three different types of meetings.
Okay.
It depends on the person, what they would prefer. We do clean the office thoroughly, and we wear masks, and so you're welcome to come in for an in-person meeting.
Okay.
We also offer telephone conferences, and so we can take the information down on a telephone conference. And we're also offering Zoom conferences, and these have been really helpful. And even though people haven't done Zoom much in the past, I'm able to walk them through the Zoom meetings, and we've had a lot of success with the Zoom meetings. But when it comes time to actually execute the documents, you would have to come into the office, because wills require that there are two witnesses and a notary. And so we can email the documents back and forth, so we can make your in-office time as limited as possible. That way that we can do it quickly and have the process completed in a short period of time.
Okay. Is there anything that you'd like to add?
Just basically that people really do need to do this. It's such a hardship on the family. I always say it's a little money now to save a lot later. Mm-hmm. In the event you don't have a will, what we have to do, depending on the various circumstances, sometimes we can do an affidavit of heirship to transfer the property. But when there are stepchildren involved, it can become very problematic. And what we need to do in those situations where people don't have wills is we have to have two witnesses who are willing to swear under the penalty of perjury about your family history, and they can't be related to you. So first of all, finding two people who could do this process is difficult, and then asking them to take off from work to go to the courthouse to sit in there on Monday mornings. We would have to sit in the courthouse with the two witnesses and take hours off of their job. So it's just really something, if you do a little bit of time and a little bit of money now, that you can really help your relatives when you do pass away to make sure that everything's in order and that things run smoothly.
Okay. Well, thank you, Kathleen. I really appreciate your time and the extra tips and information that
Great.
Is so valuable. If you would like to get a hold of Kathleen Cassidy Goodman, she can be reached at 210-949-1000. Is that correct?
That's great.
Yes, and we'll also have some information here posted where you can reach her and also check out her website. Thank you.
Thanks for having me, Gina.
All right. Bye-bye. Thank you.